One of the most important parts is obviously hook and hook length choice. And they'd like we know that there's a multitude of different hooks and line on the market. But again, as with all my fishing, I like to stick to the ones that I've got the utmost confidence in. One of my favourite river hooks for feeder fishing, or for a lot of different fishing, is a Drennan Wide Gape. It really is a fantastic hook. It's sort of a medium hook, double maggot, two little bits of a worm. When the fishing's difficult, which it could well be on Sunday, this would probably be my number one choice of hook. Obviously, there's a few different occasions. If we're using a big feeder, fishing for big fish, then the Gamma Powers, the barbed version, size 12, size 14. Absolutely fantastic hook. This is a hook to put on when you know that what you're targeting is going to pull a bit back. It's never going to let you down. Don't really blunt that easy at all. Fantastic for a multitude of different baits. Two or three casters, worms, maggots. Absolutely fantastic hook for when the fishing is good or you're fishing for a few big fish. If I am confronted with a barbel peg, size 12, barbed, camasan, animal hooks, spade ends again. These are absolutely fantastic for big, big fish. Can't bend them. Again, just not going to let you down. And when you hook these barbel on these rivers, it is amazing just how hard they actually pull. Going on to the lines, obviously again, if it's going to be low and clear on Sunday, probably be using fluorocarbon, 012, 014, the Drennan one and the Gamma Katsu ones are my two favourites at the moment. I haven't got the Gamma Katsu one in any less than 014 at the moment, but the Drennan Supplex in 012 and 013 is absolutely bang on. Tide's very nice. If the water's going to be clear on the river, which it could well be on Sunday, then obviously fluorocarbon might just get you an odd extra bite from those bigger fish. As far as the heavier hook lengths are concerned, I'd like to use the Darwa Match Winner. Again, a little bit of a strange choice, but because you're in and out, it's quite a rough fishing, quite a physical fishing. You need a hard wearing line. A match winner obviously gives me that little edge. Probably if it's big feeders, I won't be using fluorocarbon. The match winner in 5 and 6 pound would be absolutely perfect. Going on to the hook lengths, you can see here, got 50 centimetre hook lengths. If Sunday the river's quite low and clear, this will be perfect. B560s again, which is another hook I've got here. If you're fishing pieces of worm on a very hard day, or double maggot, or even double pinky, fantastic hook for skimmers, roach, perch. Probably my number one choice for when it's really, really low. The wide gapes are fantastic too. If it's going to be a little bit harder, the B560s. I've got a multitude of hook lengths here, all tied to fluorocarbon, some tied to Drennan Double Strength, some tied to the Darwa Match Winner. But they're all ready to go, like I say, at 50 centimetres, which is one of my favourite lengths to fish with on a normal river. Like I say, that's them. Going on to if we're going to be fishing with the big feeders, bigger hooks, like I've already said, I've got the Drennan Animals, the Super Spades, again a very good, very, very strong hook. Going right the way on to the Drennan Wide Gapes, 018. You'll notice, and this is a fantastic little tip here, 5.5 foot hook length. On a lot of rivers, when you're fishing big feeders, long hook lengths can definitely get you more bites, especially when you're fishing for quality fish like barbel, skimmers, bream, and maybe an odd chub. But the one advantage you've got, you'll see with all my hook lengths here, I've got some wide gapes 12 to 018, wide gapes 14 to 016, 018, and again, I've got some to a heavier fluorocarbon for if the water's quite clear. But you'll notice on all of them that they're all tied to 5.5 foot. And this is quite simple. It's probably the longest hook length I'm going to use at 5.5 foot. If I want to use shorter, I can always cut them down. So all my river feeder hook lengths are all tied to 5.5 foot. That way, like I say, if I want a 4 foot or a 4.5 foot or a 2 foot, I've got the hook lengths done, I've got the hooks tied. It's just a case of cutting them down to the desired, obviously, the desired length. If you do make them shorter than 5.5 foot, obviously, it cuts down the variation in length of hook length. And again, that just brings me on to something else. When you're talking about hook length, yes, hooks are important, line's important, but the actual length of your hook length is very, very important. What I tend to do on these rivers, and what I probably do Sunday, is start off on quite a short hook length. If the fishing's good, the fish will be coming to the feeder. I want my hook bait quite close to the feeder. 50 centimetres is the perfect starting length. The fishing gets harder and I want to catch fish on the drop, catch fish that are away from the feeder, I go on to a slightly longer hook length. This is something that I do think about a lot. Definitely when the fishing gets a lot harder, especially when you're fishing for an odd quality fish, a 4, 5, 5.5 foot hook length can definitely get you some more bites. When you're in your room and you're preparing a few hook lengths for these feeder fishing days on rivers, definitely prepare them. I just prepare them at arm's length. That way I know it's 5.5 to 6 foot. And I know that if I want a 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 foot hook length, I've got them all there ready.